Hi everyone, this is Jieyu Zhao from UCLA. I'm glad to talk our work on gender bias in multilingual embeddings and cross-lingual transfer. It's a joint work with Subhabrata, Saghar, Kai-Wei, and Ahmed. We know that word embedding has become a fundamental technique in NLP. It maps words with similar semantics to close positions in the embedding space, and supports many downstream applications. However, recently, several studies report that embeddings reflect a society bias from the text that they trained on. For example, when finding word pairs that's parallel to man versus woman to represent gender, the model not only identifies king to queen, but also computer programmer to homemaker. In this paper, we analyze the gender bias in multilingual word embeddings. Multilingual word embeddings align the word vectors in different languages to the same shared space. It enables cross-lingual transfer learning, where we can train a model in one language and adapt to other languages. The various methods have been proposed to create multilingual word embeddings. And the one common way is to first train monolingual word embeddings separately in every language, and then align them to the same space. Now, even though great efforts have focused on improving the model's performance on target languages, less attention is given to understanding the bias in cross-lingual transfer learning settings. In this work, we aim to understand the following questions. First, we would like to know, does the language property affect bias exhibition? For example, the different gender grammatical gender systems in different languages. Does such property cause different biases in English and Spanish? Second, does the choice of target space for the embedding alignment affect the bias? Third, does the cross-lingual transfer learning also inherit the bias from multilingual word embeddings? In this work, we use gender bias as an example to do the analysis, but our methods can also be used for other bias analysis. In the following, I will discuss our analysis about gender bias in multilingual word embeddings from the intrinsic and extrinsic perspectives. Then I will talk about bias mitigation methods for multilingual embeddings. Now let's first look at the intrinsic bias. Intrinsic bias aims at understanding biases in multilingual embeddings from word level. And in this paper, we studied languages including English, Spanish, German, and French. All the embeddings are obtained from fast text. To measure the bias, we propose in-bias score, which is calculated by the average distance gap between a target word and an attribute word from different gender groups. And the target word contains pairs of feminine and masculine occupations, for example, the medical and the medical here. And the attributes refer to the corresponding gender seed words, such as Aya and L here. If there is a gap between the distance of the occupation and the corresponding genders, it means this occupation shows discrimination against gender. And to conduct this analysis, we collect a data set containing over 200 pairs of occupations and 10 pairs of gender C words for each language. So how does the bias exhibit in different languages? Here, x-axis is the different languages, and the y-axis is the intrinsic bias score, which is shown previously. And the original here means these are monolingual embeddings before we do the alignment. So we found that Bias commonly exists across all the languages. And among the four languages, German and French show slightly stronger bias than English and Spanish. And we also show that the levels of gender bias in multilingual embeddings are different when using different languages at the target shared space. Now, for example, here, the blue bar stands for the bias in the monolingual embeddings before the alignment, just at the previous slide. When we align them to the English space, the bias increases, as shown in the green bars. And the bias decreases when using Spanish at the target space, shown in green. We believe this is related to the different gender grammar systems in different languages. Next, let's discuss the extrinsic bias. In this part, we study how the bias in multilingual embeddings affects the downstream tasks. To conduct the extrinsic bias analysis, we create a multilingual bias dataset following the 2019 paper to first extract biographies from Wikipedia based on the pattern, a name, age, and occupation, and then extract the binary genders based on the gender pronouns in each language. In this work, we use the occupation prediction and the evaluation task and use the average performance gap between different gender groups across all the occupations as the extrinsic bias evaluation metric. We first analyze the monolingual portions of bias using different embeddings. For example, here we show the results on English and the Spanish portions respectively. And the top row is the result on English data set, while the bottom one is the result on Spanish portion. The left figure is the overall performance of the occupation prediction task. And the y-axis is the accuracy. And x-axis is the different embeddings we used. So here we show the results using the original English embedding and the English embedding aligned to Spanish space. And the figure on the right is the bias score for different embeddings. So from both experiments, we show that with the embeddings aligned to different target space, it influences the bias in this occupation prediction task. Now let's look at the bias in cross-lingual transfer learning. When we transfer a model that is trained on English to Spanish and vice versa using the multilingual embeddings. The arrow in the x-axis stands for the transfer direction. For example, the left bar is the result transferring from English to Spanish, and the right one is from Spanish to English. We found that the extrinsic bias exists regardless of the transfer direction. We also do the analysis with contextualized embeddings by replacing the fast text embedding using multilingual BERT embedding. And the top row is the result in English portion of bias dataset. And the bottom one is the results when we do the cross-lingual transfer learning from English to Spanish. We found that using multilingual BERT, it helps to improve the model's performance in both cases. But similar to fast text case, the bias still exists in both monolingual and cross-lingual transfer learning when we use this multilingual BERT. In this paper, we examine the existing bias mitigation method by aligning the multilingual word embeddings to a Debiased English space. And the top row is the result for intrinsic bias analysis, and the bottom one is the result for extrinsic bias analysis, where we transfer from English to Spanish. So for both cases, we found that aligning to a debiased English space helps to reduce the bias, but it cannot completely remove the bias. In conclusion, in this paper, we analyze bias in multilingual word embeddings from both intrinsic and extrinsic perspectives. We collect new datasets for such bias analysis and show that bias commonly exists in different languages. And the bias in multilingual word embeddings propagates to downstream tasks. A different alignment target space affects the bias in both intrinsic and extrinsic levels. And using a multilingual BERT, we can improve model's performance, but the bias still exists. We also show that by choosing a specific alignment target space, such as Spanish or a debiased English space, helps to reduce the bias, but it cannot completely remove that. Now, we encourage more novel algorithms to be proposed. Now, data and codes can be accessed through this link. In this representation, I'm not able to cover all the experiments, and please refer to our paper for more analysis. Thank you.